Yo, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Today is super exciting for a multitude of reasons, but mainly I'm just really stoked to bring the E36 back on the channel. I really haven't touched the E36 mechanically since March of 2021. It is now February the 4th of 2022. Okay, so there's been kind of a lot of reasons why the E36 has kind of been on the back burner. It hasn't really seen very much money, time, or effort on my end. It's kind of just sitting. As for today, I really want to bring this car back to the house so I can jack it up and really tear it apart. Really, actually, I'm gonna tear it apart. And I'm kind of stoked and kind of nervous, but the car's been sitting for so long at this point that something needs to get done. I have parts for it. I've had certain parts for it for over a year now that I just haven't put on the car. I run out of time. And I'm just bummed that I haven't been able to like drive the car. The car is not to the point yet where I feel like I can trust it to drive it to events far away, and I would like to get it to that point, so nothing's gonna change if I don't do anything about it. I will also acknowledge that there was no video last week. I tried to film something, it just didn't pan out, so I didn't upload it because it was garbage. All right, I'm gonna get the car in a second, but I did wanna open this up on camera. So if you guys remember a couple videos back when we went to Winter Jam, my buddy Breno from Atlanta came all the way out to California, and he's been really working on his brand, and he does make some very quality stuff. So I just wanted to say, you should go check out his brand because he makes really, really dope stuff. So I'll put the ad in the description and I'll put it on the screen. So if you wanna go follow on go and maybe, you know, get some stuff next time he drops. It's really quality stuff. This is obviously my first impression, but it's good stuff. Another thing I'd like to point out, the reason I'm kind of opening this on camera, a lot of people don't do this, but it's super awesome to get it embroidered. It's not like a screen print where it's gonna, you know, wash off. This is a super quality sweatshirt and I'm stoked on it. Anyways, it's time to go get the E36. I'm super stoked. I don't know if you can tell, I don't know if it translates, but I haven't brought this car back home for the longest time, and I have so much stuff to do to it. I don't have very much time, but I have a lot of stuff to do to it. You see it? This is the ride to the storage facility. It's not that far away, so I figure instead of bringing a car and leaving it there, we'll just take this guy. Now that the E36 is finally back after almost a year, we have some much needed maintenance to catch up on and some things that I've neglected ever since I purchased the car that I should definitely do. And it's all in part to make it more reliable, and so I trust it more. What we will be doing is servicing the transmission. I have neglected to do this. I have not done this yet. I don't know the last time it's been done. I can look back through the service records and find out, but you guys have seen the binder for this car, it's nuts. And I would like to just do it and get it, you know, done. That way I can do my own service intervals on the transmission fluid. I shouldn't have to do it for a very long time after I do it, unless the transmission comes out for whatever reason. Whole nother story, but we'll be servicing the transmission as well as the differential. I have not done the differential either. Don't know how much fluid's in there, and I have definitely abused this car way too much to not do the differential fluid. So we will be doing that as well, and I'll be covering the whole process. So let's get into it. My least favorite part about doing anything on this car is jacking it up corner by corner. You can do it from the front subframe, but because this car is so low, it sucks. You can drive it up on wood or whatever. Subscribe to the YouTube channel and I can buy quick jacks, because this shit sucks. By the way, I just opened this as I was jacking up the car, but big shout out to Max from Germany. Thanks for watching the videos. All right, as you can see, car is up on all fours, which is great. I still want to get each jack stand higher. It's just super nerve-wracking, as I'm sure if you've ever jacked up a vehicle, I know. It's not rocket science, and I've done it a million times, but it's always scary doing it in a very confined space like a garage. I just want to say that if you haven't worked on your car in a while, or if it's like something that you really enjoy doing and for some reason you just stopped doing it, just go do it again, because it's like super fucking awesome to get back to working on this thing. And yeah, I'm like so stoked. I cannot express it enough. I don't know why, but it is super cool. And I'm glad that people watch the E36 stuff, and there's been DMs I've gotten and received that people say, hey, where's the E36 content? Or I love your E36 content, and I'm from here, so-and-so, from here, this or that. And that stuff is really cool to me. It does actually motivate me more to get stuff like this done and to record it, because it's definitely a bitch to record everything. But it's really cool to get that feedback. So if you guys ever have recommendations for videos, stuff you want to see, I'm so open ears to that. I'm going to work on creating a Discord for the YouTube channel. So we'll do that a little later when the audience is a little bit bigger, because as of now, I think I'll probably have 3 or 4 members. But if you guys want to see that, let me know. I'm going to get back to jacking the car up. All right, I know the lighting is piss poor in here, but the E36 is completely off the ground on all fours. It is pretty high off the ground for these jack stands. I have not had the car this high ever, I don't think. But it's good because I'll have some room under there to actually work on it. We are going to be replacing the selector joint. I don't know when, but I need to replace it again. So that entails pulling all the shift linkage out again. So if you've seen my previous videos on that, it's definitely not a walk in the park. So I have kind of given myself enough room to account for that. And then I'm working on stuff in the rear, I'm working on stuff in the front, so it's just best to get it leveled. The jacks are normally sitting in the cracks, all wonky, but really, I did my best to get this car as straight as I could in here. And then keep in mind, I gotta put another car in here. So there's enough room to work, and this will be its home for, I would say, realistically speaking, probably 2 or 3 months. I basically drove the car for like a year the way it was and just lived with some of the issues that it has. And now it's time to correct all of those things, and we're really gonna go, you know, 100% on this car. I've expressed that a million times, but this is a forever car for me, so I really want it to reflect that. I want the work to reflect that, and there's a lot of things I only want to have to do once, so taking time and using quality parts, you'll see. All right, it is the next morning. I didn't bother filming anything last night. I just got the car up in the air anyways. It's already dark during the daytime, so filming at night was just going to be a pain. Anyways, we got the supplies here, and we're gonna go into what you're gonna need for this job. Keep in mind, I would just recommend doing your own research on oil, I guess, because everybody has a different preference, and one application might be different than another, so just keep that in mind. But it's all relatively the same. The process is the same, and we're gonna go into that. And I will also mention there's great articles and great videos, and they're gonna be linked in the description below. If for whatever reason this doesn't help you, I know sometimes the filming gets away from me, so just keep that in mind. I will have resources down below for you to follow, because that is what I'll be referencing, but I'll still do my best to capture what I'm doing. All right, so I'm gonna quickly go over like what I picked up, and this is pretty subjective to what your application is. And obviously if you have the same exact car, maybe you'll just use what I am using. But from my research, the information on this is Redline 75 weight 90. This is specifically for an LSD. So to my understanding, initially when these cars came out, BMW, the OEM oil in this car was 75 90, and then I guess a little later they decided to start using 75 140. So I'm not sure which to use, but this is the one I picked up. It's not gonna kill the car, it's not gonna kill the differential, I'm sure it'll be fine. And then I got drain plugs that came with the oil. This is just some Redline D4 ATF. This is automatic transmission fluid, but on these manual cars, they do take the automatic transmission fluid. Lastly, you're gonna need one of these. I picked this up at Harbor Freight, and I have little to no faith in this just because build quality is super not great. But you're gonna need a pump to actually get the fluid up into the differential or transmission. So I'm not sure how long this is gonna last, but hopefully it'll last at least for today's use. All right, we're gonna start under the car. We're gonna start at the differential. As you can see, here's the differential. You got a drain plug down there and a fill plug right above it. Basically textbook type of, good safe practice is to pull the fill plug first, make sure you can actually get that out. So if you end up getting the drain plug and getting the fluid out and then you can't get the fill plug and you can't fill it back up. So I'm gonna go ahead and crack that guy and then we'll get the drain plug out. I'm back with a 14, and in typical fashion, the parts store only had a half inch drive, which means this is going to be too long to get to the fill plug because it interferes with the trunk. You'll see what I mean, but I'm gonna try something. I definitely don't recommend that you do this, but if you're in a pinch, this might work. Again, say that this is not something I recommend that you do, but this does interfere, so I can't use the half inch drive. So what I'll be doing, reluctantly, is using a vice grip. Now, if they had made a 3/8, this might have been possible, but the parts store is dumb and they don't do that for some reason. So I'm gonna literally get on here. Yeah, it's not moving it, unfortunately. I'm not sure what I can do about that. Unless, now this is really fucking dumb and it definitely shouldn't be done. But give me a second, I just thought of something else. All right, so here's my idea behind this. I'm sure this is all easily avoidable if you just order tools in advance for it. I'm sure most people have a 14, and I just happen to not have one, and the only 14 that they sold at the parts store was this half inch. So what I tried to do initially is use a vice grip, and that didn't work. It was just sliding all over it because there's nothing for this to grip on. So because this head is pretty long, and here's like a new drain plug, you'll see when you put this in there, you have that little gap in between. So what I'm going to do is put a 14 in between it. You see, you put the 14 there and then you put it in the drain plug and you can get it out that way. Hopefully that will give us enough leverage. I'm not sure how tight that guy is in there, so we're going to find out. But that is my idea, and I think that's the only other way that I'll be able to do this, unless I drive somewhere else and try and find another 14. But realistically, if this doesn't work, I'll probably just have to do something else. Okay, if I can get enough hard hits in with the mallet here, this might... That did the trick, there we fucking go. All right, I've done something incredibly stupid, but it had to work because nothing has gone right so far. This pump was supposed to just fit most gear oil bottles, but it doesn't fit the Redline gear oil bottle. So what I did is I snipped the top of it off to make this wider, and now the pump goes in there. So hopefully this will work, because otherwise I just cut up a bottle and I would like to cap off the bottle if all this doesn't work, and, you know, save it for next time. So this has to work now. Mallet it is. And there it goes, just a fuck ton of hits. Uh-oh. Oh, that is brown. And it's draining pretty good. It's draining better than I thought. It's probably gonna take a while. I'll pick up the camera when it's done, and then we'll put the new shit in, pump the new shit in. You can see it's still draining a little bit. I'm gonna go ahead and take the fill plug out now. And the diff fluid doesn't look awesome, but it doesn't look horrible, but it's just good to change. Again, like I said earlier, we'll just be able to start our own service intervals with this. The old one has a crush washer in it, or on it. And I don't know if you can see that, but the old one has a crush washer. The new one has a little O-ring on it. So I'm not sure what we're gonna do about torque, because I've looked, you know, far and wide for the torque spec. I still need to buy a Bentley manual. It's kind of dumb, I don't have that yet. But yeah, I don't have the torque spec for it, and it seems like people are just not torquing them, which is fine, but I would prefer to torque it, obviously. I apologize for not providing a torque spec, but I could not find one. And realistically, if I find one before this car goes back on the ground, I will torque it properly. But as for now, it's not my main concern. It is now time to put the differential fluid in the diff. I'm not really stoked about this part because I have to sit here and fucking pump that dumb bottle and the head doesn't sit on it right. So We'll see. I have 2 quarts of this stuff. I'm not sure how much it takes, but I know it's under 2. Oh, that's gonna take forever. That will take forever. As you can see, we have the bottle and we are pumping it into the diff. So I'll just continue doing this until it's full and we'll move on to the transmission. All right, this guy is now finally done. So we can go ahead and put the fill back in. This would be much easier with a quality pump or even gravity fed, honestly. If you just did gravity fed anything, probably be better than this fucking pump. But I had to trim the bottle a fair few times to make sure I was getting everything out of it, because it takes close to the 2 quarts that are provided in the kit. A good snug tighten, but I'm not gonna wrench on it super hard. It's got no ring on it, it shouldn't leak. Okay, that is, I would argue, pretty snug. Maybe we'll give it okay, that's awesome. All right, it is now time to start the transmission fluid change. Only thing that makes it different than the differential is basically you're just doing the transmission with different fluid, but the same process. So again, start with the fill plug and then do the drain plug after that. It is gonna be a 14 millimeter. And you'll see you actually have a nut that this grabs onto. The only thing that absolutely sucks is hanging out underneath the car, like completely underneath it.
I gotta say, this fluid smells like shit.
All right, this bolt right here is the drain plug for the transmission, and you'll see up to the right,
that is the fill plug, and this is the drain plug.
I will be back with the breaker bar. Unfortunately, don't have the leverage for that, which sucks, because I'd like to just get the fucking thing off. All right, this camera lens blows. I cannot use it anymore. I need to buy another one. I just put a little bit of PB on these. So we'll see. They're not coming off even with a breaker. I'm glad I'm trying to at least get them out. But I would like to change this fluid, so hopefully I can get them unstuck. This might be a horrible idea, but I'm out of ideas. So what the fuck am I supposed to do? That fucker is on there, to be honest. There is, like, no way. In fucking possibility. No way. No fucking way. I think I got it. I think I fucking got it. I literally am using scooter bars at the moment. Okay, now I know that's loose. See how hard the drain plug is. All right, camera is dying. I gotta get another battery, but the fluid is draining, so we're gonna put the new fluid in. I'm not gonna film.
All right, E36 now has new transmission fluid and new differential fluid. The only thing we really got hung up really bad was that one fill plug for the transmission. It is always something with this car that keeps me from getting something done fast and efficiently. But really, it didn't take that long, but I did struggle with that fill plug for at least an hour. And yeah, I'm done now. And next week, we are going to tackle the selector joint, and we're gonna finally, hopefully, really get the shift linkage tight again and get it sorted. And it'll finally shift like a proper car. With that all being said, hopefully you guys did enjoy this video. I know, super long one, and these videos always turn out this way. If you watch the E36 videos, they always turn out like this, but I don't mind it. I think it's fun for the most part, but if I had somebody to help me film, that would be ideal. So hopefully maybe next time I do something like this, I can get somebody to help me film. But I'll see you guys in the next one. Stay tuned, because E36, we're just getting started with V2. So yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.